Hello and welcome to D6 Tricks, where apparently my Stream Deck has decided the buttons that turn your microphone and Discord on and off, we're just gonna have them not work. So that
I
was
love
fun.
When that happens. Fuck, it's the yeah. best.
Let's fucking go. I'd had to do it manually, you know, like some kind of caveman with an OBS setup. All right.
This has happened to me on more than one occasion. I feel your pain.
So, for those who don't know, hi, I am Alex. I run D6 Tricks. Allegedly, one day it's going to run an actual, like, tabletop RPG campaign. But right now, it's just me chatting with my long-suffering friends about whatever tabletop-related things I want to do. Sometimes I stream, sometimes I don't. And speaking of my long-suffering friends, we have Atwas.
My long-suffering has nothing to do with you, by the way. Hi. Can't get rid of me.
And we have Kristen.
You're only minorly responsible for my suffering. I touched foam wrong.
Suffering just is a fact of life.
Yes, exactly. Wow.
Wow, I can't believe it. I just can't believe it. I can't believe we're suffering.
I can't believe that Jim did this.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Look on the bright side. If this never happened, you'd never have those fun, crazy stories about your crypto bro OT.
My crypto bro OT!
Your crypto bro OT! Let's go!
Today I learned he's such an intense, like, GigaChad side hustler that he doesn't like dogs because dogs get in the way of things.
Oh my god!
What the fuck? The more I learn about this man, I'm like, holy shit.
Oh my god!
This man
How
is
many
a character.
How many pump and dumps have you been a part of? Are you in like 30 like Bitcoin NFT like Discord servers? Tell us the truth.
Yeah.
I was like, how was your weekend, Chet? And Chet said, I'm sorry to derail things, but I have to tell you this important thing.
Right, of course.
Okay. So I'm like, how was your weekend? Oh, I got into woodworking. I'm like, oh wow, that's cool. That's surprising. And you know, in my head, I'm like, wow, that's almost a not dude bro thing. I'm so proud of you for expressing. I was like, yeah. So we're discussing, you know, cool tables and things like that. He's showing me how fancy hand-carved tables are, like, you know, $30,000 when you sell them online. He's like, you know, and that got me thinking, if I got even minorly good at this and then sold a bench for like $700, that would be a good side hustle.
Wow. God, I wish I had like one billionth of the motivation that these people have. Holy shit.
Don't you disrespect that Sigma grind set?
We were talking about like the student loan crisis, and I was like, listen, college is way too expensive. She's like, I know. My wife and I had to flip houses on the side to pay for my master's.
On the fucking side?
Forget Sigma. This man is like the alpha and omega male. Like, holy shit.
Got that Jeremy Renner side hustle. Yeah, I'm an actor. I'm Hawkeye, but that's just the thing I do on the side.
I'll give him this though. He's a great occupational therapist.
Thank God.
You can't deny him that.
Thank goodness I touched foam wrong, or we wouldn't know that this man, one, exists, two, somehow lives in rural Michigan of all places.
Amazing.
Glorious.
Anyway, trans rights are human rights.
Trans rights are human rights. There's a bundle right now on itch.io. The link is typed manually on the screen, and Atwas has been nice enough to paste it in the chat. It is like 500 or so independent tabletop products for $5. Like, that is one of the best deals of your life. Money's going to a good cause to support trans rights in Florida, which, you know, needs it right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it's got some legitimately really good stuff in there. Like, one of the things on the front page is Gubat Banwa. We're not going to be looking at that because it's a bit involved for a quick dive. But it's like a tactical Filipino kung fu, if I remember correctly. I may be getting the nationality wrong, in which case I'm very sorry. But it is an amazing read. I got it for $30, and it's worth that much before this bundle came out. So, basically, what we're going to be doing is taking a quick dive into admittedly some of the shorter ones, like some of these are one page. We're not going to go into a deep dive into mechanics. We're just going to be looking and being like, this looks really cool. And you could have this if you had this bundle. So instead of like major deep discussions, we're going to be looking at things like, I don't know, as I go to hide the thing. Like, I don't know, if it hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe, I'd have been married a long time ago. I'm going to find him and kill him by Anna C. Webster.
Promising.
Okay, so this title haunts me for one reason and one reason alone. You know how, like, little kids, they get stuck on movies and songs?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
My younger sibling, who I am 6 years older than, when they were young, they were stuck on two songs.
Oh, no.
One of them was Barbie Girl, which, you know, certified hood classic. Yeah. Right there. The second one, you better fucking believe it was Cotton Eye Joe. You better fucking believe that bitch was playing all the time.
No! I'm sorry. As soon as you said Barbie Girl, I cackled because the combination of these two songs have such an energy.
It just feels like Barbie Girl and Cotton Eye Joe are at opposite ends of a political spectrum.
Alright, so Cotton Eye Joe.
Cotton Eye Joe. The goal was to find and kill Cotton Eye Joe for what he did to steal your lover. But there's a twist. There are many types of cowboy. Cowboy is a state of mind rather than a profession or gender.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
A classic cowboy. Pirate. What's a pirate but a cowboy on a ship?
That's so fucking true.
Freaking a fantasy cowboy with some very tiny disclaimer text down here.
Okay.
Yeah. Hold on. I can zoom in. I have the power to do that.
I want to read this tiny text.
Please note, by selecting this class, you enter a legally binding agreement to not use any form of fantasy racism in play or ever.
Nice!
Oh, yeah.
And Space Cowboy! See ya,
oh,
Space
boy.
Cowboy! Yeah. And then there's also Cohesion Mode, where everyone selects the same archetype in game setting, or what I would suggest for a game called If It Hadn't Been for Cotton Eye Joe, I'd have been married a long time ago, I will find him and kill him. Chaos Mode!
Chaos Mode!
Everyone selects different archetypes.
You know what would be a good homebrew archetype?
Wait.
Samurai.
Samurai cowboy, let's go.
What is a samurai but a historical Japanese cowboy?
Alright, so you just need a pencil and paper, some decks, and here are your stats. You got rootin', tootin', shootin', and a fourth stat that depends on your flavor of cowboy. Which is sloopin', suitin', pukin', and roostin'.
Oh my god. These are amazing. Holy fuck.
So, brawn, charisma, guns, survival.
You
and anytime
know.
You do... Yep.
I'm sorry, I'm looking at the whole, like, okay, so as a pirate, your thing is that you're good at using a ship. Space suit, and you know how to survive in space, and I'm just imagining fucking trying to, like, the universe in which you find a way to mutually apply both of these.
Spaceship.
We've all seen Treasure Planet, right?
Yeah.
that's a good point.
Yeah. And then, hey, you play blackjack in order to do actions, which is awesome, honestly. Yeah, that's the quick version of this, but yeah, you want to draw higher than the GM and 21 secret success. So it's blackjack.
That's pretty cool.
And then there you go. That's it. That's the entirety of the PDF. For if it hadn't been for Cotton Eye Joe, I'd have been married a long time ago, I will find him and kill him.
That's amazing.
Yeah, this alone, I would say, is worth $5.
Yes, oh, yeah. I agree. Holy shit, this is amazing.
So, like I said, this is not going to be a deep dive into a lot of these. This is just going to be staring at just some of the stuff you can get in this bundle and being like, this is cool. Would I play this for Cotton Eye Joe? Absolutely. Yes,
absolutely,
I would play this.
Yes, I would play Cotton Eye Joe.
Fuck yeah, I'd play Cotton Eye Joe.
This is amazing.
Yeah.
I cannot get over the stat names. That alone is worth the price of admission here.
Yay! So that's number one. There are a couple more. I put these in semi-random order. So next is Love versus the World, which is Caltrop Core, if you're familiar with that. That uses D4 as its system. So don't step on any of these. You will die.
You will take 1d4 damage.
It's a Scott Pilgrim versus the World game!
It's a Scott Pilgrim game by Aubrey Knotts.
Amazing!
Yeah. So, yeah. Basically, you're getting to fight the League of Evil Exes and play as Scott Pilgrim characters. So, for people like me and Kristen who grew up with Scott Pilgrim, fuck yeah. Sign me up for the concept already.
You fight because no ex will ruin the experience of listening to your date's not-so-great band for the first time.
Exactly.
By God, I'm gonna be there to provide that lone clap once they finish a song.
For sure. Yeah. So, basically, Caltrop Core, dice pool system, pick the number that's the highest out of all the different dice. You want a hot 4 and not 1. I love how mixed success is still number 3 because, you know, it's Scott Pilgrim. He's kind of a failure, as is. Yeah. 3 stats. Fight, love, and music. And then start with 1 in each stat. Can't go above 4. Pick 1 stat, move it up by 1, and start with one of these moves. All of which is Scott Pilgrim references. You can use your love stat for fight rolls. Yeah.
They just left.
They just left, aka the best joke in the movie. Once per session, you get out of a scene when you get jumped out a window.
Scott free.
Scott free. Honestly, more games should have an ability that says, I just leave.
Mm-hmm. You jump out of a window, but we're at the park. I jump out of a window.
And yeah, Caltrop Core game loop is have fun. Oh, you always get interrupted by an ex. Give them backstory and special power. Defeat them every time you fail. You gain experience, and experience makes you better. The fail to gain XP is an awesome system, honestly.
That's neat.
It's pretty cool. I like Scott Pilgrim. I would try this, I would say.
I would absolutely try it.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, and Caltrop Core is simple enough. Like, since you can put the guidelines for Caltrop Core in these 5 pages, while also including what Scott Pilgrim is.
What is Caltrop Core, actually?
It's the D4
system. That's the D4. That's the base game system. So, like, Dungeons & Dragons is a D20-based system, and Caltrop Core is, like, the base game system. It uses D4s. You can put all kinds of themes on it.
Yeah, and you roll dice pools with your stats instead of having them be additive.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now I know.
Speaking of game systems, the original game system I don't believe is included in the Trans Rights bundle, but there's something called the 2400 system, which is really awesome. And someone made a hack of that. Not this one. Not this one.
I was looking at that one earlier.
Yeah. called 24 Blue, where basically, the 2400 system is made to be one of the most homebrewable and adjustable systems out there. So just, pick one of these, here's how to roll, it's pretty neat. And 24 Blue takes that to the extreme by saying, hey, I took what was, you could find a system through like 12 different mini modules, and made an entire ass subsystem based on it. So, when I say subsystem, blah, 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 dice, you can have bigger sizes of dice to try and get better numbers. 5 plus is what you want. Sometimes you get D12s, which is awesome. Create 2 skills, 2 traits, 2 items, can be anything, blah, blah, blah. How to run, steps like this, pretty neat. Mm-hmm. And then here are a bunch of tables to say, hey, make your system anything. Do you want a Western with vampires? Let's go. Do you want a post-apocalyptic stone ocean? I think that's JoJo's Bizarre Adventure, but doofus. Yeah. You want a World War War? Let's go!
Oh, God. World wars pitted against each other.
Two world wars.
World war versus world war.
World War II faces World War I. Let's go.
Woof.
Woof.
But also, Kristen, dinosaurs.
Dinosaurs.
Dinosaurs. An yeah.
Cyberpunk dinosaurs. Let's go.
Okay, I would be so in immediately.
So yeah,
this
combining is
combining the two best things.
Cyberpunk dinosaurs. A rules light system in four pages, one of which is the cover, I need to remind you.
Is a banging cover.
Yeah, by Diego Barreto.
Nice.
This kicks butt.
It does. Cool. I like the risk system. It kind of reminds me of like the role outcome system or cost system. It reminds me of Blades in the Dark, which is a funky little game. It is also pretty cool, but this is cool.
This is neat.
And then also included was a more specific way to adapt the 2400 system. Not this one. You wait your damn turn.
We'll get to you, Crownless. Just you fucking wait.
All right. Also by Diego Barreto, he has a little mini series called the 18XX series, which is games that use the 2400 system set in the 1800s, and this one is kind of based on like Blades in the Dark, but solving mysteries like the Gumshoe systems of Cthulhu Dark, and kind of, or alternatively, mystery solving like Brindlewood Bay. But basically, hey, you're a bunch of conspirators finding people who are using the railway system as it extends all across the world to do some bad shit.
No. Just for Kristen, it was a lo-fi train conspiracy.
A lo-fi train conspiracy! Let's go!
Just for you. I feel so hashtag blessed.
Yeah. So yeah, same basic rules and system, but defined character classes. You've got the classic detective, aka the type that will appeal to Kristen.
Yay! My perfect man.
Your perfect man, a drunken loser who also
falls. Drunken loser.
Sybil Cordova is an apostate. Just saying.
Sybil Cordova is absolutely an apostate.
Oh yes, absolutely.
Because it says take a car and a suitcase full of cash.
Take a car and a suitcase full of cash.
Powerful family. Perfect. Easy.
Perfect. Fun. Slots right on in there.
Yep.
Listen, that's how I play a one-shot RPG, is I go, okay, can I fit one of my OCs in here? Bam, there we go. And Sybil is fortunately built to go anywhere.
Sybil Cordova fits in almost every genre.
In almost every genre, except ironically, Kaiju Girls.
Except Kaiju
Charlie's
Girls!
Because Charlie's more anime than Sybil is. What's at the end of the line? Ooh.
What's at the end of the line?
North Carolina. Wait, what? Sorry. I like everyone has magnetism when it comes to their own like home city when seeing it in places, and I'm like, docks? Docks?
Docks? 1800s though.
Different Charlotte? Different Charlotte must be. It's inland.
Yeah.
It's like a 3-hour drive to the beach.
Yeah, I'd be like, there's surely a lot of cities named Charlotte.
I mean, obviously, there is a Charlotte in Michigan, but it's pronounced, you know, Charlotte, even though it's spelled like that.
Because it hates
you. I think they do have trains. I don't think they... Ironically, it's one of the most landlocked towns in all of Michigan, which is saying something, because there's a lot of water in Michigan. Charlotte sucks. It's the fucking worst.
there are 11 places named Charlotte.
Ooh.
Oh, good. We're on the same page. The only ones close to water are the ones in Maine, New York, and maybe, question mark, not really Louisiana. Bizarre. Anyway, I'm legally required to say that North Carolina and Charlotte is superior.
Yeah, the The one by, the one in New York, there's one in near Rochester, at least, which is close to Lake Ontario, so that would have docks.
Yeah. Well, there you know what? I'll say this. Charlotte, North Carolina has, like, two major lakes with a pretty large boating scene, so sure. Why not?
Sure.
Sure. Anyway, yeah. There are cults in various places who use the train for bad things. I like trains.
Oh, boy.
Sorry, one more aside. Question mark? Siberia?
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 This is cool. We love ourselves a randomly generatable table. That's so cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I love random fun. Tables. I am a less sucker prep, for random tables and trains.
It's a good time.
I'm gonna go defy the thing that keeps popping up and just manually click on the next one, which is a very important one. Apocalypse Wow! an RPG about saving the world by Mr. Ray, and the only ones to protect it are the world's traveling Owen Wilsons.
Choose the which Owen Wilson their character is.
Oh, yeah. Thank God, Lightning McQueen is the first one.
Lightning McQueen, of course.
Thank God. Would
be... I can't. This is amazing.
God. First off, skedaddle, A+ word choice. Palette. Spelled wrong, but I really like the mental image that's going with the palette that they included. Wow.
And all Owen Wilson start out with two wows.
2d6, baby. Fucking easy.
Yeah, 2d6 easy system, my man. It's
I can't believe that this game is combat heavy. a good chunk of the rules.
Ooh. I can't.
So, related to this, Owen Wilson starring in a movie about Bob Ross coming up as Bob Ross, but there's also a movie coming out by Christopher Nolan about J. Robert Oppenheimer. My stepfather got those confused. Yeah. Oh. Wow, I am become death, destroyer of worlds.
I took a sip of tea right as you said that, like a fucking idiot.
Please.
You fool. Why would you ever drink anything on the page about Owen Wilson?
Right. I'm an idiot. I'm a fool.
Feel free to homebrew your own Owen Wilson. Or even a Luke Wilson.
The Photoshop job. Like, the cover is pure art. I love this. God, yes. Look at that skull.
God, the stats over there. +2 spy. Cause small. Cause small.
Oh yeah, small. Yeah, that's the guy from Night at the Museum. That's why.
That's amazing. This is the, you know what, fuck it, we don't need to look at any of the others. This is the greatest thing that's ever been made.
No, there's so many good ones.
There's a lot of good ones.
There's Apotheosis and Crownless, we'll get there.
We'll get there eventually.
We'll get there.
Yeah, look at this.
We're gonna stop midway through this one because it's one of the longer ones, but this is Fist. Basically, it's Doom Patrol meets the A-Team meets Metal Gear Solid. If you have no idea what to do, call in Fist, the Special Strike Team!
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, get some six-sided dice, players take turns talking to each other, let things flow naturally, and then you gotta make some characters. And all the sample characters are furries, so we know exactly what kind of character that Fist wants to make.
Mm-hmm. Amazing.
You may be someone who can turn into a ghost or control bees with their mind.
Promising.
Yeah, pick whatever. Procure a character sheet, pick two traits, and those traits are your character sheet. 2d6. Good luck.
Boom. Fuck them up.
Yeah. Yeah, for instance, Colonel Kraken. He has many knives and many limbs. Boom, you did it. Howling Hound, punk who wants to fight for exploited workers, is also a skeleton cyborg.
Yeah!
Amazing.
401, a Soviet sniper with a Gatling gun. Fuck yeah.
Traits right, berserker, right. vehicle. Which I choose to believe some Transformers fucking shit.
Oh, absolutely. Mm. That's the only option.
Skilled as a driver? No. Transformers shit.
But you can interpret that however you want. Vehicle? I am the vehicle. Let's go. Anyway, medic, telekinetic. Let's go.
Yeah.
And then, yeah. We know the 2d6 system. Don't roll below 6. Try to roll above 10. You probably won't. Let's go.
That's powered by the apocalypse, baby.
That's powered by the apocalypse. There are no saving throws in war, my friend, said the explanation of hit points.
I steeple my fingers. Yes.
Yeah. Ooh, custom content. Cyclops. Here's stuff to do. Cyclops' fist through a dark mirror. They are the man.
Oh!
All right. Mission generator. Blah, blah, blah. Yes. Shadowy government agency wants to mutate humans or animals to obliterate a rural town.
Sorry. I love the one option. Turn the Cold War hot.
Turn the Cold War hot. Let's go. I'm trying to find... There we go. Traits index.
Oh, these are good. These are good.
These are so nice.
Love that. Oh. So I recently got turned on to one of the, I wouldn't say the internet's older things since it's still relatively recent, but I started reading a web serial called Worm, which is basically it's like a dark, not really grim dark, but it's a superpower thing. It's a superpower thing and it's fucked up. And that's all I can think of when I look at weird powers now is like, damn, there's so much weird shit you can do with this.
Look at
it's
all so this weird good. Shit.
But yeah, look up Worm by Wild Bow. It's pretty good.
Oh. Yeah. You have a Highlander option. There we go. That's the one.
Yo. Go. Oh, that's cool. There can only be one.
There we go. There's nothing in this book that is going to top Highlander. This looks interesting. I might read it more later. I want to play a Highlander. This is the most dangerous
Hybrid
thing.
Slaps. Hybrid takes me back to my Neopets role-playing board days.
Right.
Oh. Shark. Hummingbird. Let's go.
Whenever I see stuff like this, all I can think of is the Batman Beyond episode about people getting spliced with like animal genetics, and it was, you shouldn't do that. It's you know, you're fucking yourself up, and you know, I'm just like, that would be the coolest fucking thing though. It would be so cool.
So
why
bad,
would you
though.
Say this is bad, Batman Beyond? This looks so cool. Anyway, this is very promising. Looks fun. Yeah.
Looks really
limbs.
Neat. Yeah. There's no Excellent. Limit to how many lovers you can have. It's a life lesson from
I
Fist.
Mean, technically, yes. But consequences. Consequences indeed.
Consequences indeed. I played Persona 5.
Remember. Open and honest communication is your gateway to success.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Anyway, shitbirds!
Shitbirds!
Oh, sorry, that background image, holy fuck. The googly eyes? Huh. Remember, you suck.
you suck! You're a trash person and everybody knows it!
Being a scum dump got you further than anything else in this life, and you're not gonna change unless you absolutely have to. Mood, babe. Fucking mood.
No, you don't have to!
Oh. Your stats are getting into trouble and getting out of trouble.
Choose one you're good at and you're bad at the other one.
The trash licker in charge is gonna tell you what's up. Holy fuck, I love this author so much. Oh, this is so good. Oh, this is the best euphemism for a game master ever.
Every shitbird has to act every scene because they need to make this about themselves.
Remember, you suck. Before you act, ask yourself, what would someone who sucks do right now? Something like that.
Honestly, big Disco Elysium vibes right there.
Yeah. 2d6, get a 7 or higher. You're still a shitbird. Someone hates your guts, but you win. Fill in one of the boxes next to commitment. 6 or less. Do the same for crisis. And then, at the end of each scene, check to see if all 3 boxes next to either crisis or commitment have been filled in. If all the crisis boxes have been filled in, you've got a choice to make. Answer this question. Are you going to be a shitbird forever? If no, tell the trash licker in charge what you're going to do right now to change your ways. If yes, or you filled the box next to commitment, you're a shitbird till you die! Tell the trash licker what you gained from being a scumbag. Now your shitbird's either too goody two shoes or too scummy for the group. They get kicked out and a new shitbird joins! Only the first shitbird to fill in 3 boxes that anyone's seen leaves. They're all shitbirds and you're in charge of them. What does that make you? You're the trash licker in charge, shitbird!
Also, get the dirt on these fuckos.
Get the dirt on these.
Be cool. Use some safety tools.
Use safety tools, yeah. Always use safety tools.
Honestly, love that safety tools have been being included in like all recently published games. It's nice. 100%. Good stuff.
It is nice. Also be cool. Use some safety tools.
So, just for the writing and the googly eye background bird, I would absolutely play shitbirds.
Yes, I would play shitbirds. Ask yourself, what would someone who sucks do right now?
Someone who sucks do right now?
So great.
All right. It's amazing. And next is another
nice.
Another more complex one, but one I picked specifically because I thought it would appeal to Kristen. Dethrone the Divine.
Oh boy! It's about gods and shit.
By Matt Mr. Ray Adams. And basically, gods are dicks, but godlings can take up their weapons to dethrone the dicks. Let's go.
Oh nice! Charlie the game.
It's Charlie the tabletop game.
Charlie the tabletop game.
Yeah. So, basically, skills with the No Way Home system. I'm sure there's a better word for it, but 5 or 6 is a success, and you want successes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There goes the shitbirds. Damn, that guy had like. Sorry, this truck just drove by and he had like the most massive like monster truck tires on like a regular ass truck that I've ever seen.
Bitch, that is a shitbird.
I was gonna say a shitbird just drove right by. God.
Also, there's divine dice, which can be used in reaction to your divine domain, which has a wider success range and can grant additional options. So essentially, Charlie.
I was gonna say, wow, a game where I can play Charlie.
This is just straight up Charlie the game.
Charlie the game. That's fun. I like that.
Yeah.
Love fighting some gods.
Some more experience. Failure against experience checks. It checks level up, like I said. I love the system where fuck up and you get better.
Mm-hmm.
When a character levels up, they can gain a special trait, domain, or an acolyte, which will do nearly anything required, as long as it doesn't violate their personal morals. Vincent, go do that guy!
Oh fuck my god! Yay!
Yeah. Get your racism, transphobia, homophobia, ableism the fuck out of here. Let's go.
Nice.
Yeah.
That's rad.
Yeah. If this bothers you, talk with your group before going forward. And if an agreement can't be made, play a different game. Fuck off.
Thank you for understanding. Smile, 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 smile.
Smile. Yeah. Blah, blah, attributes. I'm scrolling down because there are some archetypes in here. Okay. Yeah, Origins. So.
Ooh.
Rebel God, the outcast Rebel of the Pantheon. So that's Chaos God.
New God.
New God.
Baby.
Baby.
Baby. Ooh,
Star Child.
So sorry. Living Idol examples: Tickle Me Elmo,
Kermit
the Frog.
Mm-hmm.
Woo!
This is amazing. This looks like a good time.
Yeah, Animal God Grumpy Cat.
Grumpy Cat. Ah, yes, the most powerful of all gods.
But
this is a good time.
And this is Charlie the Game. You fight gods who are dicks.
Yay!
Then there's like following and fear. Get more followers, idiot! This is Charlie the Game.
Get more followers, idiot. I'm working on it.
You sure are. Get more followers, or alternatively, get followers, idiot. You got it, boss.
Yeah.
Got it, boss.
That clip art. Oh, that's so good.
Oh, it's amazing.
Coin flipping
RPG.
That's really cool. Sorry, I'm such a sucker for when the mechanics kind of help along with the fucking vibe of the game. It's so good. It's just good. It's just good. Also, big props to going back to the first game where G's are not allowed in skills. It's an apostrophe or nothing.
Apostrophe or nothing.
the skills are fibbin', haulin', lobbin', pickin', peepin', sneakin', scrappin', and holdin'.
Yeah, exactly. You got it, boss.
I'm dying that peepin' doesn't have a fucking apostrophe in perception. Is...
Nope. Perception.
Ooh, a comeback token. Sorry, I'm all over the place, but like, that's wild. I fuck with that. That's cool. After a player finds a particularly creative solution, the GM may award them one comeback token. Hell yeah.
Yeah. Mm. And it can be spent to turn a failure into a success through cartoon physics or flat out coincidence.
That's amazing.
Also the games company, Tone Thief Games, A+.
A++, 10 out of 10.
Example item, disguise glasses, a grappling hook.
Disguise glasses.
Polaroid camera.
Football helmet.
Excellent. This looks fun.
Yeah, this looks fun. You really gotta get the tone for it because you're just cartoon goons working for Mr. Mysterious.
Mr. Mysterious.
the vibe that I'm getting, if I had to condense it into something, it's the fucking weasels. From
Roger Rabbit.
Yeah. That's the vibe.
Excellent. This is very good.
Yeah, very good. Okay, but what comes to mind for me is way more obscure. But only because we've been watching a lot of it in movie night. So so Free Willy had an animated series.
What?
Yes, it did.
Good.
Okay, so Free Willy had an animated series. Jesse, the kid from Free Willy, is actually a truth talker, which according to his Native American best friend, means he can talk to animals if he understands their truth. This allows him to talk to Willy and friends.
Yes.
Now, Willy also has an arch nemesis. Willy's arch nemesis is a cyborg. Who was knocked into a propeller by Willy one day when he was smuggling arms across the Canadian border, I think. And so now the cyborg, known as the Machine, has all sorts of schemes where the primary purpose is not to make him money, but to kill this one whale.
And loot things.
Okay. I'm gonna force people to make a mental connection if they know the fucking comedy skit of I'm the Machine. I am the Machine. Just consider that.
God, yeah. I do not know this one.
It's a very funny comedy bit.
It has to do with being in Russia and not knowing the language.
Yeah. 90s cartoon, by the way. So it was Captain Planet as fuck.
Featuring
Hell
such...
Yeah.
Listen, the machine... The guy playing the machine has had the most fun that anyone has ever had doing anything.
Yeah. They're working just... together! I hate it when they do that!
Anyway, it's a great show. People should watch it. I cannot recommend it enough for watch parties. It's so great.
You don't watch Free Willy seriously unless you have a group together with you. It's one of those shows that really grows on you for how dumb it is.
So anyway,
I'm told the second season, which we haven't gotten to yet, adds even more really stupid plot developments, and I am all for it.
Hell, I'm so excited. But yeah, so anyway, you got it, boss. I definitely agree. These guys work for him. Mm-hmm. God. Ooh. But yes, so this looks fun.
It does. Speaking of things that are gonna make my voice gravelly, family. My family. How familiar are you with the Fast and the Furious series?
I took the Universal Studios fucking lot tour recently last weekend, and holy fuck, I am so glad that I bring earplugs now to like everything. It's loud. Have they gone to space yet? Asking for a friend, the friend is me. Have they gone to space yet? Because it's only a matter of time.
The 10th movie is coming out soon, so
there's a chance.
Yeah, we got two more movies for them to go to space.
Yeah.
I've only seen the first Fast and Furious movie.
Okay, well, it's nothing like the rest of the Fast and the Furious movies.
That's
because
what I've gathered.
Same.
Just escalation. So,
see, the first Fast and the Furious movie is Point Break. It's just the movie Point Break, but with Vin Diesel instead of Keanu Reeves and the other guy from Point Break, whose name I forget at the time. The other Fast and the Furious movies are about supermen who are invincible and can do anything as long as they're in cars. One of my favorites is Dwayne The Rock Johnson grabbing a nuclear missile and throwing it back at a submarine. Which he can do because he's in a car. All while talking about the importance of family.
Oh my god.
So, Love by the Quarter Mile is Fast and the Furious, the tabletop game by Mark Meredith. Each character has three stats. Fast, furious, and family.
Oh, that's incredible.
And also cars.
Well, the cars are just kind of an extension of their powers, basically.
Of course.
Yeah, the cars are irrelevant. Dwayne The Rock Johnson is a Superman outside or inside a car. He contractually cannot lose, and neither can Vin Diesel. And neither can Jason Statham. So when there's a fight scene between the three of them, the writers are like, fuck.
No one's allowed to lose.
No one can lose.
God, amazing.
Yeah.
I love the word gist.
Gist.
I love that. That's so good. Who are you? What makes your character tick? What's the gestalt here? I just
gestalt.
Good fucking word.
A good word.
It's a good
also
word.
Arguing parentheses family mood. Fuck off. Right? Leave me alone. Mood. Hey. Leave me alone. Excuse me. Leave me alone.
If your emotion ever exceeds family, the argument ends. The loser decides whether it becomes a fight or the racer backs down.
Amazing.
Races aren't purely about speed. They're about intensity, grit, while you're racing. You don't have to use fast. You can use family to race. My family.
Oh, that's so good. Also, I love that towards the bottom on the right-hand column, it said after each session, you can like choose to advance and change up your stuff. That's cool. I love that. Sorry, at the end of a story. That's, I fuck with that. I like that because, you know, I think we've all question mark perhaps. We've mostly been in scenarios where we play long-term characters and they grow outside of their stats or abilities in terms of personality and stuff like that. So I think that's cool. I think it's neat.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
It's a good time.
It's good time.
Also, quick chat. A fight between those actors would be like an anime where two characters punch each other's fists and the world explodes. Yes.
Is that not just a Fast and the Furious movie?
I believe that's Fast 9.
Fuck off. No.
Yeah, that's where they fight John Cena, I believe. But he turns into a good guy by Fast 10, which is coming out.
Oh, thank God. Oh, thank God.
Because he's family, you see.
Of course.
John Cena does not work as a heel. Sorry. He's too good. The vibe is too good, guy.
Yeah. Now, I would play this, but only after making my long-suffering friends watch some Fast and the Furious movies.
I'm sorry, Kristen. We have to watch all the Fast and the Furious movies.
Not all of them, just like five onward.
That's so many movies.
Okay, but there's a scene where they drive and are towing a safe down the Brazilian highway and smash into every cop in Brazil.
Okay,
and that's
okay,
number
okay.
five, and it gets stupider and crazier from there.
I express cautious curiosity.
Yeah. Now,
thank you, Mark Meredith, for our lives.
Thank you, Mark Meredith. And,
oh wait, yeah, it was in the ride where I think towards the end of it, Vin Diesel leaps out of his car going 120 miles down LA freeway and suplexes a drone.
I'm out here with my fucking 3D glasses on. Everything is breaking. It's so fucking loud. I'm a sensitive person. Loud noises make me, yeah, it fucking hurts. But like, he just jumps on this fucking drone and hangs off of it as you're racing down this freeway. I just
breaking from the drone and then just suplexes it into the highway.
I'll take care of this. And like, fucks.
And then teleports ahead of you so that he can meet you at the end and be like, now you're part of the family.
God. That's amazing. Exactly. The A plus.
A plus plus. The family.
The family.
Universal sure was an experience.
Sounds like it.
I will say. It was also a disappointment because Universal Hollywood, the Mummy ride, doesn't have flamethrowers. What's
no!
the fucking point? They have no flamethrowers. They have no animatronic of Brendan Fraser.
What's even the point?
The ride still slaps, but if you want the ultimate Mummy ride experience, go to the Florida one instead of the Universal one. But if you go to, the Hollywood one. But if you go to Hollywood, fucking Waterworld.
Waterworld
stunt show. Yeah.
They crash a plane in Waterworld. Let's go.
They crash a plane. There's all sorts of fucking jet ski shenanigans. It's awesome. Yeah. Anyway, we're off topic.
Sounds
like a good time.
You know, yeah, pinned where that was. Pinned where they fight Jason Momoa. It's very important that we have where they fight Jason Momoa.
Oh, pinned. Did I pin it on accident? My apologies. But also, very good next plot.
Where they fight Jason Momoa.
They fight Jason Momoa. Spoilers. We're not looking at anything. The Night of the Scarecrow. So,
what a great name.
Yeah.
Really. Yeah, truly.
So, do you know The Quiet Year?
Yes. Yes, no, that was so fun. I played it with Xander and Bro when people were, I think, unavailable for COC. It's so fucking cool.
So, basically, The Quiet Year is using playing cards to narrate how a city is built. This is a game that uses the Quiet Year system, and it uses it to show a scarecrow zombie apocalypse. Yeah. Which I love because, one, I love scarecrows as a horror movie villain. Don't at me. They are underrated as fuck. And two, it proves that The Quiet Year can be made into a lot of cool stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
Well, basically, pick some relationships with the characters, because it's a horror movie. Everyone knows each other. You begin with two truths. These are things that represent your character. Don't lose them, because then the scarecrows get you.
I'm a little disappointed that there is no one lie that you also pick.
You choose to not lie.
And also one of the truths, dog owner.
Yeah.
Horror movie fan. Good stuff.
Murder podcast listener. Yeah. So if you lose all of them, you have nothing left. Everything you know about yourself is false.
Nice.
And then desire, you want to do something during the course of the game. You might not. Scarecrows might get you. And then introduce each other. When it's your turn, decide what you want to do. At an appropriate time, draw a card to influence the scene, which gives a complication.
Yeah.
Answer any questions the card asks. Make a roll if it seems difficult. 1d6 to start, 1d6 if truths help you, 1d6 if you help out. Get the highest one. You do it well, get a new truth. If the highest is one, you fail so badly, one truth about yourself is gone.
Oh god.
Ooh, that's cool though. I like that you can gain new truths. That's nice.
Yeah. And then, yeah, here are the cards showing what happened. Start at noon, that's the hearts. So basically, hey, there's some weird signs of scarecrowing all around. Short farmers arguing with the rich farmers, they both accuse the other of stealing dozens upon dozens of hay bales. Which do you think's behind it? There's a trail of scattered straw tailing toward an open door. Why don't you go to see what's inside? This is the 100-year anniversary of the Harvest Massacre. Why wouldn't anything like that happen today? And then Ace of Hearts, advance, because the scarecrows get up and walk. And then, dusk. Time to prepare for the zombie apocalypse that's coming. Scarecrow gets hold of your arm, holds on so tight it hurts. Hardware store is having a sale. Let's go. And then scarecrows are gathered towards you. There's no time. Where do you duck for shelter? Night. Hunker down. Don't look outside.
Oof.
Yeah, so stuff like power goes out. Someone across the street in a safer spot opens their door and waits to come in. You might make it, or you might not.
Oh, man.
Yeah. There's a back door open that has been for some time. And then Ace of Clubs, Scarecrow spots you. They're here, good guys. They're here.
Oh, no.
Yeah. When the scarecrows are in your shelter, fuck yeah. Everything's going great. You find a lighter and some fuel. You might burn in your attempt. Do you try it? And then finally, Ace of Spades to end it, and you'll see if you survive. And that's the plot line. It's real neat sounding.
That's fun. Seems like a good time.
How will you warn people when the scarecrows return in 100 years?
How will you warn when the scarecrows return?
Thinking about those radiation cats, dude.
Radiation cats?
Yes. So, apparently, there's, so the problem of long-term nuclear waste storage is a thing, because it's a very, very long term. And so people try to think about, well, how do we protect the areas? How do we, you know, try to set things up so that people far in the future who maybe don't speak our language don't fuck with this shit and kill themselves? And one of them was a proposal to genetically engineer cats to glow in the vicinity of radiation and then pass down like folk tales and songs about glowing cats in danger.
Wow.
it's very good.
Amazing.
Anyway, booty shorts with this is not a place of this is not a place of
this
honor.
This is not a place of honor. Them.
Excellent. Very good.
Very, very good. The scarecrow walks at midnight.
Ooh.
Actually, he walks at dusk, but you know, you do you.
You know.
Details. We need phases.
They walk when they it walk. Is dark.
Mm-hmm. Just going out for a stroll, having a good time.
Going out for a little walky walk.
Little how'd you do?
Seems like a fun time.
It's a great time.
Fucking corn.
Fucking corn.
All right, so before I open up this this next one, how much do you know about the video game Doom?
Let's fucking go. Which one? Because yes.
Well, I think this is based on the plot of Eternal, but based on the boomer shooter era. So
yes.
So basically, God. Bible verses: demons are pouring out. Kick their asses. That's the plot of Doom.
Yeah.
There's some more shit about like, there's a portal on Mars that led to hell, and the demons came out, and then angels were like, we're gonna take over, but all that really matters is you kick their asses! And that's Doom. Or Hellgrinders, basically. So essentially, if you want to play as a character, running around a whole lot, punching the fuck out of everything, this is the game for you. You can kind of tell what the tone of it is based on the number of pentagrams, the little word art here.
Yes, yes.
Yes. Yeah. What was your name? Brad. How'd you die? Bees.
Bees?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why were you dancing
Dio?
So funny at the time?
Dio?
Dio?
Ronnie James Dio, yeah.
Judge reference?
Ronnie James Dio would be more in tune with the era, I think. So
hell yeah.
Yeah. Can you die? Yes, but then you get better. So you got stats. Roll 1d6 based on your stats, and you got classes. Gladiator, where you just run in and punch the fuck out of things. And one of your powers can be everything is chainsaws.
Everything is chainsaws inherent.
Mm-hmm. Evil dead baby, let's go.
Evil dead baby, let's go. All right.
Bro, and then just,
you're so angry that you destroy everything around you, which is nice. Then you got the Marine, which is the classical Doom guy that goes in shooting the fuck out of everything.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Blah, blah, blah. Berserker, your boots, fists, helmet, and gun butt are nearly as deadly as your guns. There's a infamous comic that tries to adapt Doom into a coherent plot line, but the plot line of Doom is basically kill demons. So it has like 6 to 8 pages explaining what the Berserker power up in Doom goes by having the guy run around going, you are huge! That means you have huge guts! Rip and tear!
Rip and tear until it is done.
I will say, for Christian's benefit, so it's canonical that like the OG Doom guy has a pet rabbit, and the reason he went on his murderous rampage is because the demons killed his rabbit. In the newest game, Id took a portrait, like a fan art portrait that was made by someone of Doom guy holding a rabbit, and they put it in the game, and it's just very good.
That's amazing. A plus.
Imagine making fan art so good that the fucking developers put it in. Hell yeah.
That's fucking rad. Good for them. Oh boy, a priest.
A priest. Rainbow in the dark. Oh yeah, this is Dio, based on the guy, the musician. 100%, it's that guy. And last but definitely not least, a bard.
That's a choice. I love that. Your powers are fueled by beat.
Yeah. Voice like a horny angel. Let's go.
Nice.
Excellent.
Yeah. So then basically, hey, this is a very simple game. It's based on Doom. Roll around and kill some demons, and then kill some angels because they're also bad, and then go kill the Demiurge. Easy.
Oh, the Stussy-S, A+.
The Stussy-S!
I actually really like games that have like a set end, like a set short end. I say this as someone who perennially is like, I want to run a one shot, and then things are like, oh no, this will be a two or three shot, but A+.
A+.
Seems like a fun time.
Seems nice. Blah, blah, blah. Weapons. Blah, blah, blah. Enemies. The mob. Biblically accurate angels.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Nice.
And also moral crusaders, the worst kind of crusaders.
Oh, no. Self-styled Avengers of Heaven, a real drag.
Yeah.
Celestial cyst.
Ooh.
A werewolf, an electrical gremlin that can possess any hardware. That's me. That's me.
That's you. That's just Atlas.
That's just Atlas.
Hell yeah.
My kind of woman, the Blood Valkyrie, 12-foot tall warrior queens who love only war.
Oh boy!
Yeah, sure, there's a skeletal dragon, but Blood Valkyrie, my kind of woman.
Blood Valkyrie.
So true, Bessie.
So true.
Then you got the bosses. Hello, my name is Dagon.
Excellent.
Yeah. Then you got bosses, archangels, Uriel, whose attack is pushing you off a cliff. And the Demiurge sucks. Just gotta keep rolling until you hit 13. And they even included cheat codes for that classic 1990s game action.
So fucking good.
That's amazing.
Including the X card as a cheat code. Fuck yeah.
Oh, just tap it, baby.
Tap it. Let's go. Code. Nice. Bring good snacks.
I like that a lot.
That's so good.
So I went to PAX Unplugged last year. And it was really cool. I played a game called Microscope, which it's like a history building game. It kind of went off the rails. Anyway, really fun. But there's one thing that the GM did in addition to the X card for things that we're not comfortable with. There was also a card on the table that was like the "this shit rocks" card, so that if somebody was saying something that you were super into and you thought was really cool, instead of interrupting, you could just like tap the fucking card and be like, "Yo, this slaps."
That's
so
awesome.
Yeah, definitely really cool thing to, I think, implement in IRL games. But yeah, this is good stuff.
I like it.
Groundless is gonna get there.
We'll get there.
Ooh, single player. Fuck yeah, let's go. Yeah,
there are a lot of like single player games. This is one of the only ones that's not a single player journaling game, because there are a lot of those in the thing, but there's not my area of expertise.
I'm a fan of those. They're really cool. Yeah.
Yeah. This is basically the game Monster Hunter as a tabletop RPG. As said by the second page. But basically, choose how much HP you want to start the game with. You can reduce it to 3 or do 10 if you want to win the game, because it's Monster Hunter and it hates you. But basically, shuffle around a bunch of cards, choose your target, put them face down, and then there are tables to see what card means what. Spooky. So basically, find the monster, roll the dice, hope it's good, because if it's not 7 or lower, you die.
Oh wow, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, and then the rest of this PDF, besides telling you how to play, here is the things that all the cards represent: Hunter Camp, Winding Roots, a humid little hole.
A humid little hole.
Mm-hmm.
Mushrooms.
And then there are some monster lairs.
That's fun.
It's interesting.
Oh, okay. I was about to ask about the HP values, because I noticed they only ever go down by 1. So
yeah.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, if this was like Monster Hunter, I'm going to hope it's low for the sake of fun. But if it's really like Monster Hunter, this would be like 30.
Yeah, exactly. Ooh, I love it when things are like contorted to fit in a particular space.
We got a square. Use it.
Yeah. Rainbow Devourer.
What a good boy.
What a good boy.
A plus.
That's just a T-Rex.
That's just a T-Rex
with some horns.
Mm-hmm. I mean, to be fair, a lot of Monster Hunter monsters are... That's a monkey. That's a big monkey.
Big monkey.
Monkey.
Okay, right. That's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's interesting. I don't play Monster Hunter very much, but I love the system of just randomly scattering cards and using that to make the world around
you. Yeah, that's fun.
As someone with no IRL friends, I'm a big fan of solo games. So it's nice to see a solo game that isn't necessarily just a solo journaling RPG, which solo journaling RPGs are fucking awesome. Definitely need to get back to the one I was playing. And there are quite a few in this bundle as well.
There are a lot in this bundle, which I remind you, is $5. So it's literally $5. Anything here looks interesting. That and... 499 more stuff is gonna be here.
$5. Here's the link.
$5.
Please. A plus.
Please.
It's $5. It's for trans rights. Please go check it out.
Please.
And in the meantime, so Atlas, I heard you like Dark Souls.
Oh. This and Crownless is next?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
So this is a much bigger PDF, so we're not going to see all of it, but this is Dark Souls as a tabletop role-playing game.
Oh boy.
Fucked up little, you know, NPCs.
Yeah.
There's a name for you, it's Undying.
It's Undying. Ah, Undying, are we? It's me, the fucked up little man. But basically, here are your stats. You died. Your other thing's important. You died. Status effects. You have curses, because you can't have Dark Souls without little fucked up frogmen that can cause you to turn into stone and then lose half your health forever.
God.
Love
or
that,
instant
love
death.
That.
You die.
You just die.
It's die.
I just automatically hear the fucking sound effect in my head whenever I see that.
You die.
Yep.
Got weapons.
Flasks.
Straight from Elden Ring.
Boom.
Straight from Dark Souls 2, but also Elden Ring. Is drink to not die, because if you don't, you died. Boom.
Yep. Kind of interesting, because, well, you know, big part of quote-unquote game design is that flasks take time to drink, but I don't see that as part of the mechanics, I don't believe. So that's kind of interesting.
There's 110 pages of this, I'm sure it says something,
you know,
about it.
True. I guess I'm just gonna have to buy the whole bundle for only
$5.
$5!
Oh, really breaking the bank.
Boom. I already have, like, tabs open of at least 6 solo journaling RPGs that I'm interested in. I might as well just bite the bullet and buy it.
Here's an interesting little thing. So, slay the Great Lords to become the Dark Lord at the end of the game. Only one person can become the Dark Lord. The rest shall perish. Up to you how to decide who becomes the Dark Lord.
Ooh. All right. What's more dramatic? Time. Yes.
Yes. Blah, blah. Great Lords, those are the tasks. That's your Godric the Grafted. That's your General Radahn. That's everything.
Mm-hmm.
Level up to get points.
And an extra flask. Nice.
And an extra flask. Or an extra flask.
I see.
Or gear, too. With the dungeon, you may introduce some fucked up little men.
Yeah.
That's fucked the proper name for NPCs in Elden Ring, Dark Souls,
correct,
that kind of game, by the way.
Fucked up little men.
Uh-huh. Yeah, so a snake wife is a fucked up little man. I don't make the rules.
It's my favorite, fucked up little man.
I like this. I like the different approaches to exploration. That's pretty nice, actually.
Yeah, it's neat. So, hey, you can just decide randomly, or you can actually plan some shit out. I don't know.
Or be it narrative. That's cool.
That's also neat.
Interesting.
So, distance is distracted between two boundaries, engaged and not engaged, which is a really good way to do theater of the mind fighting.
Yeah, so, for sure.
Yeah, you're in close range, you're engaged. If you're not, you're not engaged, with capital letters at the start.
Yeah, that's nice. That's nice. That's nice.
So,
poise. Of course there's poise.
There's always poise.
Four actions. All right.
Yeah.
Dodge roll. Love that.
Yeah. Dodge roll, which costs MP.
I mean, just makes sense because there's no stamina stat,
There's no stamina. So. Use is drink from a flask if you're doing it in combat.
Any enemies you're engaged with may counter. Woof.
Welcome to Dark Souls. You die.
You cannot do nothing. I actually like that. But, yeah. I'll say this. It's nice to have options for players to help other players, because if there's one thing that I've learned is that players always want to fucking help other players do their shit. Always. Even if there are no rules for it.
Pile more dice on. Take my dice.
Yep.
Nice.
Range. Okay, that's cool. That's cool.
Range. You want to be not engaged in order to use range. Yeah, try using a longbow in close range. Yeah, it doesn't work, idiot.
Suck it, loser.
You also sacrifice rewards if you flee, so it encourages you to you died.
Yeah, makes sense. No, I like that. Definitely, as you said, lends itself to the theater of the mind thing. All you have to do, keep track of engaged, not engaged. Boom, easy.
Boom. So, whole bunch of spells. You can only use the good stuff if you have a lot of stats in Arcane or Faith or whatever. Starting classes. It's like Dark Souls. You can make them whatever you want. It's just a starter.
There better be a wretch or so help me.
I have good news.
Yeah! Worthless wretch, let's go!
A worthless wretch, you suck ass, you're a shitbird!
Trips about in their undergarments. Beautiful.
Items, that's the things you throw at people. You definitely throw bandages at people, that's what you do. And then, equipment makes you better at doing stuff. Blah, blah, blah. I want to scroll down to get to the enemies, because the enemies is a lot of stuff that is funny, activates the brain rot of I recognize what that's from for my little monkey brain that played Dark Souls.
I am Leonardo DiCaprio pointing forward at the television.
All right. You got your zombies. You got your better zombies. And a magician who only mastered one spell. Mood.
I know. If you only got one spell, you know how to use it. Mm-hmm. I say, them being undead.
Undead.
Another skeletal dragon!
Let's go! Zombie dragons!
Zombie dragons!
Then wildlife. Rat! A rodent of unusual size.
Yeah.
I don't believe they exist.
Giant rat who makes all the rules.
Yeah. They have the mushrooms that fucking punch you out. Let's go!
Yes. Bear.
Bear.
Great! No, great. Let's go! I've been playing Elden Rune a little bit more recently, knowing that the DLC's coming out. The fucking giant bears in Elden Rune.
Fucking rune bears. Bitches.
The rune bears suck ass!
Dude, the fucking rune bear trap in Limgrave, where you're just, you know, going up there, I'm gonna kill some nobles and get myself some resources. Oh no, a fucking giant rune bear materializes. Go fuck yourself.
Yeah, it teleports in and destroys you with more health than most bosses.
Yep.
And then you win and you get 2 experience points because fuck you, it's the bear.
Suck shit, loser.
I still haven't beaten Elden Ring. I'll get back to it one day, but I've been around long enough. Ooh, demons.
Oh, demons.
Demons. Oh, wheel demon. Very wheel good, very demon. Good.
Excellent, we have the things that roll into you.
Jailer demon.
Yeah, jailer demon, huge demon wielding a tree. So, the fat man in every FromSoft game.
Yep.
Yeah. Goat man, a humanoid figure with the head of a goat and 2 cleavers. So, the capper
very
demon.
Good, very good. Very good, very good.
Accompanied by dogs, he has to be, obviously.
Naturally.
Yeah. Large snake demon with the massive glaive, centipede demon from the first Dark Souls. Mm-hmm. Monkey brain-like. And then magical conjurations. Blah, blah. Mimic. That does 10 physical damage. Have fun, idiot.
Should have unequipped your shit first, loser.
Mm-hmm. Then more magician. Poise for if you want to break something and make sure the magician doesn't smack you upside the head with a book. Creating a boss. They don't give any examples of bosses in this one. They're like, make it yourself.
I kind of fuck with that because, I mean, honestly, yeah. Yeah. That's just kind of how the great lords are.
Mm-hmm. Just like, make whatever, get a Dark Souls name generator and make Zanzibart, the guillotine of Francis.
The HP of a boss is 50 plus 10 times the number of players in your party plus 3d6. Real Dark Souls now. Mm-hmm. Also, they're immune to death, so they're immune to death. Loser.
You can't make them die unless you whack them a bunch. You gotta poke them.
Nothing really fucks you up more than dying to a status condition called death and like the loading screen being like, try to avoid death, and I'm like, fuck you.
Stop being dead, idiot.
Just stop getting killed by death.
Pro tip, reduce the enemy's HP to 0 while keeping yours above 0 to win.
To defeat the cyber demon, shoot it until it dies. Now, I hear you asking, hypothetically, what if you wanted to do an Elden Ring tabletop RPG, but didn't want it to be 110 pages?
Finally!
Let's go!
Finally we get to Crownless.
Finally we get to Crownless. So, Crownless is technically one page, a bunch of folded sheets to go into each other. I can rotate these so we don't have to flip upside down. And it comes in like a series of, I think, 8 to 10 small pamphlets like this so you can add on as needed. Like, oh, you want to cast magic? Here you go. You want specific weapons? Here you go. Boom. It's pretty neat. Mm. Yeah. Your metal soul. Choose burnished or dulled, Crownless. That is, burnished is those with hope, ideals, and kindness. Dulled are pragmatic survivalists and cunning. At any time, the Keeper can ask you to roll a metal check, determining if your soul has shifted. Accept it or roll against it. Each d6 higher wins. You must roleplay to see if you have ideals or not.
Fun.
It's pretty interesting.
Burnished, hard, I mean, crownless.
Crownless, are we? Unfortunately for you, you're maidenless.
A legacy. Rose Paladin?
Yeah.
That's just Corelli.
I have some bad news. There's no wretch.
I guess we'll allow it because the other ones sound really cool. I mean, Lunar Channeler.
Yeah,
that sounds cool.
Storm Warrior.
Marked for,
I don't know. Marked for Sin kind of sounds like a wretch to me.
That sounds so much better than like warlock or wizard or knight or whatever.
Exactly.
These are all incredibly cool.
Just oozes personality and flavor.
Mm-hmm. It describes a lot through just two words of what the thing is.
It's very cool.
Sorry, the combat results table. Okay, 1 through 6, 1 through 6. 6, iframe.
Iframe! Suck it, loser! I'm invincible in this frame!
It's a god tier flasks. Yes, 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 yes. This slaps. This is cool.
That's cool.
Yeah. This is really neat for the basics of Crownless. And I'm going to go double check without opening up what the thing was. Da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, there are 7 such sheets about being the Crownless.
Ooh,
I only have 2 open, which are the basic player's manual and the keeper manual for how to run the Crownless.
Ooh. I sure hope there are a lot of random tables in this.
There's some.
Yeah, looks like it. Huh, yes, fucked up little dude friendly NPC chart.
Yay!
Fucked up little man chart!
Also, plus one, Terry Pratchett. Also, big plus 2, fucking Charles Ferguson Avery did art? Hell yes. I love him. He's really good. He also did the Never Going Home art. And I also met him at PAX, and he was a very, very, very cool person.
Oh,
he was
that's
very
awesome.
Nice to me. So yeah, A+, good guy. Check out Feral Indie Studio. They also did Word in the Wild, which is just a drop-in fucked up shit wilderness simulator.
Mm-hmm. Fun!
But yes.
Rise, you keeper, navigator of the fogs and herald of the crownless. But basically, hey, make bonfires when your players need to heal, and choose an NPC that awaits them there. It encourages you to make fucked up little men, let's go!
God.
Fucked up little men!
I fuck with that so hard, just because it's like, yes, you are also a character in this world, loser. Which, I mean, if you know me, hell yes, let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah. Also, encourages safety tools like X-Card.
Yes.
Very good. Always love to have them explicitly there.
Votary.
Yep. That is the Emerald Herald. That is the Firekeeper. That is the Maiden.
Milena.
Milena. I offer you an accord. Didn't expect lover.
Turn your runes to strength. Establish, introduce, allow, progress. That's a pretty good 4-step process right there, honestly.
Yeah.
That's
how you do it.
God, I love single page RPGs, tabletop RPGs, just because they condense everything. A+, A+, A+.
A+. Use your imagination.
Kristen, which friendly NPC would you be the most interested in meeting? Which fucked up little man are you here for?
Which of these fucked up little men?
She considers. She is muted.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, I went to go get thing for body. What's up?
You're good. You're good. Pick a friendly NPC that you vibe with the most.
Yeah. Pick your favorite fucked up little man.
I mean, I feel like it's really obvious which one I would pick.
Yeah.
I feel like it's really obvious that it would be Aisha the Bane of Undead. I feel like that's really the obvious choice.
And of course, Pretender Gods, Ruthie the Ink-Stained, Rust of Control.
Ooh, fun.
Yeah.
It's a good time.
You can't fool me, Rykard! I know you have to change your name a little bit!
Legally distinct Loretta, the legally distinct.
The legally distinct Elden Ring boss.
Adon, more like Radon. Anyway. Nah, that's some cool shit.
Good shit.
That's some cool shit. So.
It seems fun.
It seems pretty neat. There are more of these that are included in the bundle. Go get the bundle, it's $5.
Go get the bundle. It's so worth it.
Yeah.
Even single player stuff, you're gonna get your money's worth.
And then some. So I did some like rough arranging of the middle section into vaguely thematically related things. So vaguely related to Elden Ring was Crownless and Apotheosis. And these next ones are vaguely related to Ghost Hunters because now, Kristen, I know you know paranormal home inspectors. And one of my greatest desires is, what if we could play paranormal home inspectors? But
oh my fucking god.
One
oh my
shot,
god.
Zero
please.
Crap. Let's go.
Let's go.
Yeah. Oh my god.
So there already, are three. Buy the bumble and this is half off, you know? Yeah, it's fine.
I'm sorry, wait, is this actually based on paranormal home inspectors?
No, it's based on just generic ghost hunting reality shows. But okay, we all know the best one is Paranormal Home Inspectors.
I mean, objectively really. The best one.
Mm-hmm. Play to find out.
Play to find out. Are these reality stars dead as hell?
Promising. Yep. Okay.
You need a big ratings bump. Or at least a cushy job remembering the 90s. Yeah. Make great TV by being as hypnotically awful as you can be. So my goal through, there are three of these, even though one of them is a JPEG. I will pull up the JPEG PNG and share it with you guys as we get to it. My goal for all of these is I must find a way to play as Brian, home inspector of the Paranormal Home Inspectors in all of these ghost hunting games.
I mean, valid, because I want to be Nadine. I want to be this horrible fake psychic.
The psychic who just sees everything everywhere. There's a darkness in this area.
I'm sensing a darkness in this area, an energy. It's really heavy on my chest right now.
So what you've got here, light comes through this area easily because it's right by a highway. So that may be projecting shadows onto the wall here. there are claws in the walls. See, the paint is peeling.
Because the only thing, do whatever it takes to survive, but most of all be memorable. Because the only thing worse than dying is not trending online when you do.
Exactly.
Excellent.
Okay, so there are two stats: provoke to cause drama and survive to think rationally. Amazing.
Wonderful.
All right, so pick your career: Jersey Shore idiot, Effet Brit. The show revolves around you.
Pick a very stupid name.
A very stupid name.
Oh, I also kind of like that. As a player, you're helping the director keep things moving. Thank you. More cooperative stuff with
your
GM.
Mm-hmm. Yep. The camera person.
Camera person. The charlatan. Oh, so that's Nadine.
Nadine, yes. And you're entirely fraudulent. And you absolutely must
That's
wear a
me.
Fantastic top hat.
Yeah. Oh, the academic. You know some things about this place, and you're also broke as hell. That explains why you're here. Okay, so this is Brian.
Yes, correct.
Yeah.
God, amazing. This looks like a very fun game.
Looks pretty neat. Various playbooks. British intellectual. At first I thought it said British individual. So,
British
people.
British people.
The horror.
Horror.
Excellent.
Tables to make a haunt. I love these wooden tables.
Ooh, well, every fun. Member makes a roll and you pick your favorite. I like that.
Oh, that's
Ooh,
nice.
That's fun. Nice.
Pick the show name.
promising.
Yeah. On 20, roll again and tack celebrity on the front of the name. Get amazing. Ready, world. The celebrity poltergeist highway is ready to hit the road.
Oh, man.
Revoke and survive. Mm-hmm. Two stats.
Yeah. Two stats. Try to roll under them. If you don't, you fail.
You may not be strong or smart or likable, but if you're an asshole on a reality show, you're an absolute wizard at provoking a reaction. Love that.
Love it. Now, on with the show. Blah, blah, how to play. I think we know how to play if you've ever seen a ghost show.
Yes.
Only this time there's an actual ghost and it wants you dead.
Mm-hmm.
Card or hook hand, we get it.
Manhook card or gun gun.
Yeah.
Oh, an appendix for some rooms and things you might want to know if you're playing ghost game.
Nice.
I like the ocean liner option as a setting.
It's good ocean stuff. Liner.
That's a good time.
Yeah, it's haunted boat. We got a lot of haunted boats for whatever reason.
Yeah.
Bonus Targmars.
Targmars.
Yeah. It's late, you're tipsy, and you and your friends have a brilliant idea. Let's go to Target! This is 24 first hours off, super Target.
First off, completely unrealistic. That's a Walmart. That's a Walmart night, if I've ever seen one. Even if you go to Walmart. It's late, you're drunk, you go to Walmart. Like, fuck it.
Yeah.
Target's too high classy. Class.
Yeah.
You just need to make some bad choices while at Target or Walmart. Starting with Targ 2 and Marg 0.
Yeah. So over the course of Targ Margs, you will make progressively worse choices.
God, yes.
That sounds amazing.
No one runs the game. You're all equally culpable for what's about to happen.
So what's your favorite late night fucking retail store experience? If you have one, God. I guess.
I'm trying to think through, like, I actually have not really done a late... No, that's not true.
I don't really do late night superstore experiences. Can I sub in a Las Vegas experience?
Sir, yes, sir.
Because I think it's the same vibe of a drunken idiot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So, my favorite Vegas experience in terms of people being drunk and behaving badly, we came in what's early for America, but was football non-Americano time for Ireland, who I believe was playing that day. And they were losing. And two older women... two Irish women in the bar by the casino did not like this, so they spilled out onto the slot machine floor, just punching, kicking, and dive-bombing and wrestling each other. And I just leaned over like, this is way more interesting than the video poker I am playing. I make a disclaimer, I was over 21 at the time I was doing this. I was legally allowed. It was not fun. But the drunken brawl was way more fun.
Hell yeah.
Amazing.
So that was nice. And then it was like, well, surely there can't be any more angry sports-related drunken brawls there. The hotel we were staying at had Manny Pacquiao versus Floyd Mayweather. And that, for those of you who don't know fighting sports, those are the two biggest names at the time in UFC fighting. And the match was pay-per-view, super hyped up. It lasted 2 minutes. So after that happened, the entire floor of the Venetian was filled with drunken brawlers, and that's my favorite Targ Marg adjacent.
Thank you.
Story.
That's amazing. This is killer ratings. No one's dying. No way to lose Targ Marg. We just decide the winners. It will mostly be obvious to everyone who the MVP of Targ's Marg is.
Targ's Marg is, give him Mardi Gras beads.
Target bag to wear as a bonnet. Oh god, amazing. Drinks. Everclear. Just Everclear.
Oh my god.
I had a friend in high school set his hand on fire because he was doing dumb shit with Everclear.
Oh my god.
Trying to do like the breathe fire trick. with like the fucking like 100 and plus whatever proof nonsense. Anyway, don't fuck with Everclear. It's disgusting.
Don't fuck with Everclear.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Anomaly hunters.
Anomaly hunters. Also paranormal house inspectors related. By Jonathan Savigny, whose name I probably horribly mispronounced, and I'm sorry.
All right.
So basically, we find haunted locations, you go there, destroy the haunted locations.
Okay, all right.
Goody.
So I get to play as Brian, home inspector, but I've got a gun. All right. So, as you roll, you reduce the rating of the skill that you used by one level.
That's nasty.
That's mean. But you can reset them and take a break, and it's a brief break in tension, and the GM introduces a new complication whenever it happens. Also nasty.
That's cool. Yeah. Like I said, I'm such a sucker for mechanics that work with the vibe of the game.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
What if stunts? You all die?
Six stunts!
Stunts! The cool factor.
The GM marks how cool the episode must be. Don't forget to use your skill to specifically increase that cool rating, or else you'll get cancelled.
Fun.
Choose a role. Blah, blah, blah. The Exorcist, The Witch, and The Medium.
Okay.
I think The Medium would be an 18, and then The Investigator would be Brian.
Yes, absolutely. Correct.
Mm-hmm. So what you've got there is a Wendigo of some kind. They're monsters in Algonquin mythology. Very bad.
Excellent.
Yeah. Assign dice to things your character is good at. D4 is the default, and according to that table, 5 plus is succeeding without a cost. So, if you have a D4, things are gonna go bad for you real quick.
I see.
Random tables for the monkey brain. What we got here is a were-moose of some kind.
Were-moose!
It's one of the most deadly things you can find here in Canada.
Amazing.
Yeah. And then, how to defeat and identify monstars. Stuff you can usually associate if you're genre savvy, except for the mimic, which you have to defeat by convincing them to leave. Can you go? I want you to just go.
Go. Why would you want to be here? Like, just leave.
This place sucks.
Yeah,
it's really bad.
Leaving. Fun. Okay.
All right. I like this. Right. It's nice like and it. Rules light. Has the potential to have paranormal home inspectors, Brian, so that is a plus on ghost hunting.
That's all that really matters for ghost hunting games. Can I play paranormal home inspectors, pretend? Because if I can't, what is even the point? Would you stay in your house if it was haunted?
If you knew it was haunted, the answer is always yes, for whatever reason.
They're comfortable with the finding.
Yeah, they're comfortable with the ghosts that are in their house. All right, so this next one is an image file rather than a PDF. So it's not going to pop up in my usual thing. So I'm just going to drop it in Discord and then boop, pop it up here in OBS. So you won't notice a difference. Wow.
Wow. Paranormal Hunters Organization.
This is a hack of the system Lasers and Feelings, which is one of my favorite rules light systems, where you have two stats. In the default, the stats are lasers and feelings.
Okay.
Yeah. Choose a number from 2 to 5, And if you are using one of the stats, try to roll under that number, another roll over that number. So, skeptic versus believer. Brian would normally be just a one in terms of skeptic, but I can't pick that, so two.
Two. Okay, okay.
So, you got style, you got roll, you got number, and you got goal. That rhymed, and I did not mean it to. And then you can also bring in a special guest to help with the mystery. I always want to bring in celebrities so that we can have just some D-list celebrity helping us out with hunting ghosts. To help us find the spirit, we enlisted the help of Lance Bass from NSYNC, also the voice of Sephiroth in Kingdom Hearts.
Oh yes, of course.
It always gets me that Lance Bass, of all people, was the voice of Sephiroth in Kingdom Hearts.
Listen, it's very convincing. You know, I say that, but I only faced Sephiroth once, failed immediately, and then I went, you know what? Once is enough for me.
He's too hard for your little baby hands.
Too hard for my little baby hands. I was woefully underleveled because the first time I played through Kingdom Hearts, I really wanted to know what was going on in the story, so I kept like running through all the areas and not fighting the Heartless. So by the time I got to like Hollow Bastion, I was like, wow, I'm losing a lot. I wonder why.
I'm doing real bad. Oh no.
But that meant I got really good at I couldn't fighting in Kingdom Hearts because that just means you have to parkour everywhere.
Yeah, just jump and fly fucking everywhere, and there you go, that's Kingdom Hearts.
And then you fight Riku when he's possessed and you just lose.
Yep, that's how Kingdom Hearts goes.
And then you get to see that one cutscene a million times. Kill me. But anyway, yes, Paranormal Hunters Organization.
Paranormal Hunters. If you're using a skeptic, you want to roll under your number. Believer, you want to roll over your number using your style. And if you're an expert, if you're prepared and if you're an expert, that adds dice. You want at least two, because if one die, you barely make it. And the GM introduces a complication.
Ooh.
Yeah. But if you roll that number exactly, you get insight into what's going on. Ask the GM a question, and they answer truthfully.
If you roll your number exactly, you have confirmation bias.
Confirmation bias.
That's excellent. Yeah.
And then running the game, is it a celebrity ghost? The ghost of Lance Bass. But wait, Lance Bass is right here. Ooh, a mystery.
Ooh, a mystery. Lance Bass, but you're already right here.
Then who's that? Old man Henderson.
All right. Fun.
Yeah. So the Paranormal Home Inspectors for group goal is just record activity. You don't really like do anything with the ghosts.
No, you just record the activity and you like, say,
there might be ghosts here.
There might be, but they're also, you know.
It's also highly unlikely. Brian went through, actually, and found a lot of proof that it might not be ghosts. But Nadine had a feeling.
Nadine had a feeling, so I believe her. Okay.
Okay.
You gonna stay in your house?
Yes.
Yeah.
Even though there's ghosts? Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Why is the door always opening? Well, you see, it's not... Well, you see, what the problem is that it's not quite level here, so of course it opens.
Yeah, it doesn't lock properly, and it's not level, so the door swings out. Yeah. My bathroom door locks by itself, and it doesn't have a lock. Yeah, it does.
The store has a lock on it.
The store has a lock on it. It could be ghosts, though.
Nadine thinks it's ghosts, and I believe Nadine.
Yep. I did some research, and like in this river, there were hundreds of dead bodies, and the river is a couple miles from your property, so...
So, probably those ghosts.
Probably 80 ghosts.
So someone died in this town once 100 years ago, and they're like all the way across town.
Uh-huh.
But you know, they could be here.
Could be them. A bunch of role-playing grandmas use the house next door.
I mean, that makes perfect sense to me.
Yeah, so they could be summoning ghosts with their role-playing.
Maybe you guys could it sounds like you guys should stop playing Dungeons & Dragons. You're inviting this shit in.
Yeah, you're just making ghosts, guys.
Anyway, the moral of the story is that everyone should watch Paranormal Home Inspectors. A great show. Everyone should
watch Paranormal Home Inspectors. Greatest show that was on Canadian television.
Yes, obviously.
Canadian television sure is the most television has ever been.
It's very television.
Exactly.
I appreciate that there's like multiple, like, you investigate the paranormal in some manner.
Yeah.
God,
it's a good time.
Just coming here and looking at this. Are you fellas aware of the mystery Flesh Pit National Park?
Oh yes, speaking of National Park.
Oh,
another
thing that
feelings.
I will link to Kristen.
What?
Oh, the mystery Flesh Pit National Park sure is a thing. It is a national park, and you are introduced to it via a number of in-universe brochures and other documents. So I think it would be bizarrely a little up your alley just because it's all like sort of diegetic. Kind of wild.
I love diegetic shit. That's true.
Hell yeah. I will send you a link to go alongside the I Am the Machine skit.
Oh boy.
Excellent.
Yay.
All this is to say, Paranormal Hunters Organization, which is a hack of lasers and feelings, transitions into a bunch of hacks of lasers and feelings. So for this one, you've got wizardry and bureaucracy. You're a member of the National Park Service, and also you're a wizard. Yeah. Which
Amazing.
Is terrible because you're also a civil servant who has to do paperwork. So, yeah, cool nature wizard name, or a boring everyday name, like Ren Black Hallow of the Wandering Mists, or Jim Reynolds or something. Yeah.
Okay.
Beside two strengths of the park, the animals can talk, and a weakness, the animals can talk, but they don't like you. It's back to the weremoose. The weremoose just fucking hates you.
Mm-hmm.
Another one of the most Canadian things.
Mm-hmm. So, standard thing for rolling the dice and lasers and feelings, you want more dice that roll under or over the number if you're using lasers or feelings or wizardry and bureaucracy.
Mm-hmm.
If you roll that number exactly, you get wizard bureaucracy. That's fun because I love incredibly magical stuff treated as the most mundane thing in the world.
Oh, I also love good that shit. Stuff.
Yeah. Ah, damn it, the feral warlocks are out again. Hate it when that happens.
Get my shotgun off the wall.
Mm-hmm. You warlocks! We've also got Hex in the City, which is lasers and feelings, but it's Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Oh, fun!
Disclaimer, Joss Whedon's a terrible person. I love Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Valid. I also love Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
It is once more one of those shows where I had a very, very strange childhood and adolescence. I've never seen a single episode, but I'm culturally aware of it through osmosis.
God,
hell yeah.
One year in college, I like binge watched the entire show. So I was a latecomer to this thing, but I enjoyed it. So, Serenity the Chosen One.
Has gotten herself grievously wounded in the last battle, leaving you with no prophetic visions to guide you, or convenient one-shot monster-killing powers while she recovers. Or maybe she's off recuperating with her demon boyfriend again, who knows? Also, yes, I love that example of mundane moon doors opening again, Jim. Just another Tuesday.
Moon doors? The moon door will open soon.
The moon door will open soon.
Oh my god. The personal complications list. Oh, it's good shit.
Mm-hmm.
Too weird to live. Hot ex wants blood. Is off the wizard, wizard cops.
You're using street and shadow.
All right.
So I'm seeing a lot of stuff referring to like the Seelie and Fairy Courts. So there's some Harry Dresden in here too, but it's obvious that it's mostly Buffy.
Fun.
It's fun. And
good,
then
good shit.
It's very good shit. And then there's one more of the Ladies and Feelings hacks, one that probably appeals to only me in this group. It's a hack of Burn Notice.
Oh my god. Shut the front door.
Holy shit, someone else in my social circle knows what Burn Notice is!
Of course I do. Dude, my mom was like super into that show.
My mom was super into Burn Notice!
Once more, we somehow have similar formative experiences about like weird, bizarre media looking at you, SWATcast. Anyways, nobody's seen us in the same room before, I say, looking at Kristen winking.
No one.
We've definitely been mistaken for the same person at least twice. Anyway, that's some good fucking shit. Also, Burn Notice sure was one of those shows that starts off and then goes wild. Yep. Kind of like Lost.
I hopped out around the same time that the bad guy went, Michael, you have to do crime for me or I'm going to put Fiona in double jail.
Did you watch a show called Hustle?
No.
Okay, all right, okay. Also, good show, kind of wild. I think I had Matt Balmer. Anyway, similar vibe.
Very.
Anyway, your name is parentheses, make up a cool name.
Make up a cool name.
You used to be something until one day you got blacklisted. Choose your skill value. Higher skill value means you're better at operative things. Lower skill value means you don't know cool stuff.
I actually really like that. That's cool. That's really cool. Sliding scale type stuff, for sure.
Yeah, sliding scale is definitely Laced in Feelings and Similar Hacks strengths. Because, you're either really good at being a spy, or, you can do things in regular-ass society. But yeah. I love that the game master is called the VO. A voice in the sky. What tells you what to do? The action goes okay, is another funny thing I noticed. And wow, this is the first Ladies and Feelings hack I saw that's two whole pages.
I know.
Crazy.
And just... You're in Miami. Sorry, you don't get an option. Mark where you are on the map, loser. Yeah, it's
you're
Miami.
You're in Miami, idiot. You wanted to play Burn Notice, idiot. You're in Miami. All right. So, this next game, Monarch. I'm just going to go down and describe the game first. You are dukes, duchesses, archwarlocks, whatever, of hell. The throne of hell has been abandoned for quite some time, and you're playing the game of liars and souls, or it's called something specific, but basically, you secretly give your soul to someone else, and have to guess where someone else's soul is put. And you play it by playing Spin the Bottle.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And I'm like, wait a second. Yeah. And I'm like, mm-hmm, yes, yes, hell, very nice. Spin the what now? That's what got me attracted to this game.
Fuck yeah. Dude, I love games with unconventional systems like that. Spin the bottle, fucking Jenga. Hell yeah. Mm-hmm. Also, safety tools. Safety tools. Safety
also
tools.
Also, safety tools.
Yeah. Fuck yes.
So, most people know Spin the Bottle is a kissing party game. Neither kissing nor truth or dare is the point. Although, with enthusiastic, ongoing, and reversible consent from all participants, it could be.
Ho ho! I like that. Sovereign authority.
Sovereign authority over all those who claim the name of demon. You'll need to prove your ability to deceive via Spin the Bottle.
Ooh,
so you secretly entrust your soul to one other person. They don't know. You're the only one that does.
That's cool. Also, got Coronation Compass. So many good evocative names here. Mm-hmm. Huh.
The Coronation Bottle. Let's go.
Starting with the player who last ate spicy food.
Holy fuck, that's so
amazing.
Good.
Holy this is shit. Amazing.
Also, yes, hello, Kristen. Welcome Hi. To Decide Who Runs Hell via Spin the Bottle.
That's amazing.
Hey, so, game for next meetup? I suppose.
Ooh. Ooh.
I mean, amazing. Next meetup is coming up. We need some ideas for tabletop games to play. Let's spin the bottle.
Not a terrible idea.
I guess my wish list is this and 10 candles.
Ooh, fun. All right. Oh, man. Starting with a player who last ate spicy food, take turns on the spin.
On your turn, spin the bottle, or digital equivalent. Person it lands on is your scene partner. Spinner sets the scene. Continuing character kill, it comes to a natural conclusion. You've got two objectives. One. If the partner is your anchor, you must set the scene of when you gave the soul or when you decided who'd be the anchor. If it's someone else, lie your ass off and pretend they're the anchor.
Oh, a clash on the battlefield. Very good. Yes. As homoerotic as you can get.
The most Excellent. Homoerotic. And waltzing in a ball for double homoeroticism.
Excellent.
Why not both? A Why battlefield both? Ball. Armored ball gowns.
Fuck yeah! Say more right now!
Sounds amazing.
Yeah. On your turn, if you've landed on your anchor, you may guess who another heir's anchor is. If you're wrong, well, you're kind of boned. Spin as normal.
Okay.
If you're right, that person must confess to it. You've won the test of bonds and the game ends. Describe your ascension and coronation. The revealed anchor decides, with the knowledge of that they hold the soul of one of the competitors, whether they crush it or not.
Oh, I like this.
That's
oh,
really
this
fun.
This is nice.
Oh, fuck yeah. Honestly, like, with HIO games, never disregard a game that doesn't have fancy art or layout, because this is just a PDF, but holy fuck. This looks fucking cool.
Mm-hmm. This looks awesome as all hell. Get yourself the right game. Doesn't even have... the right game. Well, obviously it's this game. Get yourself the right group. Doesn't even have to be a group where people are into kissing each other. And this is two and a half pages of awesome.
Yeah, this looks like a really good time.
Hell yes.
Hell yeah. Normally here's where we take a break, but we got like five more things, so I figured we'll just go straight through and end whenever.
Makes sense.
I'm good with that.
Yeah. And speaking of one of the games, oh no, goblins. You're having a normal day, and oh no, goblins.
I know that maybe is supposed to be a knife, but I choose to believe that it's a blunt.
Oh, fuck yeah.
I thought it was a microphone.
Gonjured up.
Sick beats.
That too. So true. So true, bestie. Excellent. I'm so sorry. I have to say this, but... That looks like my partner's handwriting. Which, I say that with the utmost love and also with the knowledge for you all that I fill out the forms and write the checks. God, it's so good.
My handwriting is also medically incomprehensible. Let's go.
Yep.
God, I think we talked about it anyway. Having a normal day and oh no!
Goblins!
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 Yeah. Each character starts out with 8 points. You got a job, a hobby, and something you do or have.
Gets fast food, having an affair, has a bat.
That's a bat. This is, I'm gonna use my affair stat to fight these goblins.
God, the sheer, like, the sheer range you have in jobs and hobbies. Cashier, accountant, doctor, skiing, role-playing, cosplay.
Hey.
A fucking plus.
Amazing.
Mm-hmm. Ah, D4s. We got another stat.
Going back to Caltrop like, core. Cool.
Yeah. Hmm. We fuck with that.
Same system as the Scott Pilgrim game.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. I'm actually surprised they haven't name-dropped Caltrop yet, but I'm sure we can maybe get there.
They don't name-drop Caltrop!
Yeah. Maybe it's at the bottom, who knows, because I'm pretty sure this default D4 results table is, like, the same for Caltrop Core, but eh, whatever.
Probably.
It'd be like that. Complication pool, though.
Ooh.
The complication pool. Anytime a check adds one or more complication dice to the pool, add that many, and then if you have 5 or more, roll all of them.
Oh no!
I love that.
Mm-hmm. Complications can also occur without rolling on the table. That's just for fun.
Oh, God. First off, I want to point out 2 things. One, you really made a PDF and you kept the little undersquiggle for
the NP underneath.
for incorrect spelling. One. Two.
Nice.
Goal. Finish a group project due tomorrow. Excuse me. This is supposed to be, escaping from reality. Leave me alone.
Well, that's where the complications of goblins come in.
Oh no, goblins.
But also, remember, kids, don't cross the picket line.
Don't cross the picket line.
Don't cross the picket line. And also, last minute. This game was made for me. All of the shit's super fucking relatable. Last minute holiday shopping? Me.
Yeah. Arrival appears? Me.
Arrival appears.
Get some food late at night? Me. Missing cookout because it's not on the West Coast? Me. I do want to say helping a friend is never a complication for me.
Aww.
I say batting my eyelashes at you two.
Gosh.
God. Obviously, yeah, that's a goal.
That's
exactly.
Exactly.
Just like causing a complication is a goal.
Yep.
But yeah, this looks cool.
Mm-hmm.
It looks fun. Oh no, goblins! Can we just appreciate Goblin Blunt for a little bit more?
God, yes.
Oh no, Goblin.
Smoke weed every day. Disclaimer, marijuana is legal in my state. Disclaimer. MARIJUAJUANA. Someone dies in this elevator.
Someone dies in this elevator.
Oh, I hate that.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah.
The weed condition is dying in an elevator?
Yeah,
okay. That's cool. I fuck with that. That's good. The wind condition is dying? Hell yes.
Fuck yeah, let's go.
A plus. The dice roller does not have to personally decide the effect that's canon should be done as a group. Yes. Yes. Which elevator are you in? Oh,
these
are good.
Elevator to the moon?
Oh, moon these elevator. Are good.
Yeah, the moon elevator opens in 3 days.
And house, depths of the ocean, action movie. Okay. Sorry, fellas. I have to ask, what do you picture when you hear the word shiny elevator? Because that sure is a That sure is an adjective.
Interesting description.
So you know those elevators that are like in glass tubes on the sides, on the outsides of buildings? Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I'm picturing that.
Mm-hmm. Oh, God. The elevator from my hotel at Universal to the top of the hill, where one of them was broken. I mean, it's fine. It wasn't broken in a super significant way or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
But like, an elevator in an elevator warehouse. So I have to say this because I did mention my home state previously. So each elevator has a certificate of, you know, inspection in it, right? In the United States, where you go in an elevator and it's like, this elevator was inspected by and meets the, So I know this and I remember this. This is something that will stick in my head for eternity, but the inspector in charge of the elevators for North Carolina, at least when I lived there, was Sherry Berry. C-H-E-R-I-E Berry. And I just, so fucking good. Thank you, Sherry Berry, for making sure our elevators were safe. Anyway, who's in there?
Who's in there? A knife and some duct tape.
Sir, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. A tiny model of the elevator you're currently in. Dracula, let's go!
Oh.
A ghost who is afraid of the dark.
The public domain Sherlock Holmes.
Yeah, it can't be the Sherlock Holmes that likes women. That's kind of some public domain.
Sherlock Sholmes, though.
Sherlock Sholmes, on the other hand, fuck yeah.
The dice roller's father's brother's nephew's cousin's former roommate. God, this game understands me on a primal level.
How do you react to the discovery of this? Who's been there all along? Would you say you're safer? Has anyone died yet? No, continue.
Portal appears along the left wall, voices emanating from it.
Remember this number. Remember.
Has anyone died yet? No. Let's continue.
Has anyone died? No. Let's continue. Follow this scenario until someone dies in the elevator.
Yeah.
So good.
There's a horse loose in the elevator.
I'm gonna raise my hand up and I'm gonna say, you know what the ultimate homebrew of that option would be? Release two pigs and they're named one and three. Boom.
Boom.
You ever think about how large pigs are? Anyway.
They're very big. Pigs are crazy big.
30 to 50 feral hogs, something. Yeah. Follow the scenario until somebody dies in the elevator.
Later.
That's amazing. Good.
I tell me.
God.
Yeah.
So you mentioned amazing names. I'm sorry, I have to stop everything because I just remembered something and I need to give this knowledge to someone. So I visited my cousin a couple weeks ago and they told me about this friend they had who was a vasectomy doctor, and you are not going to believe this person's name.
Oh?
Okay.
Is it Dick something?
Dick Van Slicer.
Shut up.
It was his actual fucking name!
No!
Oh my fucking god. No way!
That's really his name!
No!
Hold on, I need to see where Jir is because this is too important to leave alone.
Tragically, he's passed on, he's no longer alive, but he was real.
His legacy alone! Incredible, impeccable, truly artistic.
I'm sorry, I just
pulling in value.
I suddenly remembered it, and I was like, I slammed my fist.
No, so important, so true. Thank you.
Most important.
Dr. Dick Van Slicer lives on through our memories and hearts. Remember, you never truly die until somebody forgets your name. And holy shit,
no one's going to forget ever.
With a name like that, you can only get one job.
Oh my God. I think he did it for the meme.
did it for
he
me.
He had to. He had to.
Yes. Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Sybil Cordova?
Ooh.
This machine has meat in it. A game about killing the Eldritch Nightmare that is your job.
I already love that. Ooh. Okay. Bastard Crew? I'm already loving this. Redacted? Let's go.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We already have some big Delta Green vibes.
Yeah.
All right.
This is basically Eldritch Horror in the style of a corporate presentation.
That's amazing.
Corporations aren't people.
They're much worse.
Remember, capitalism is an amoral system.
Mm-hmm.
You ever think about how capitalism is actually only, like, 100 years old anyway?
You know.
Considering the weeping eye saw you take those staples, Gary. You will be getting a demerit!
Demerit!
Demerit! Thank you, Grissom. You understand me on a fundamental level.
Exactly. Two demerits.
Two demerits.
This machine has meat in it. Excellent.
Yeah, it's a game of hope against despair. It's fighting capitalism.
I fucking love that.
What do you need to play?
One printed employee record, two different colored pens.
Bonus points for including the U in there because it makes more phonetic sense. Anyway, I will die on this hill.
I mean, you're right. Oh man, so Steven is Canadian and he moved here when he was like 3 or 4.
Mm-hmm.
So he told me how he was in a spelling bee and they had to spell the word color. So he spelled it the Canadian way and he lost.
Oh, no.
And to this day, he's so mad.
No, I would be too. Steven is the most valid person on the face of this planet. He is correct. It just makes sense. That's phonics works.
He's like, if I'd had the, presence of mind for, I honestly would have argued for it, but I was just so flabbergasted that they told me I was wrong that I just had to accept it.
Oh, you are, baby. Anyway, company time, free time. Company time, free time.
Free time.
Ooh, telephone number? Interesting. Interesting. Okay.
Interesting.
After all, there is power in true names and in true email addresses.
That's so great.
Every team you play, let's play on company time or on free time.
Mm.
God. Free time converse. Anything that takes place over from the office, off the clock, away from the building, people in the horror. God. Fun times.
KPI is.
The presentation of this is so good.
Right? It is basically exactly a corporate presentation that is hiding evil Eldritch nightmares.
God.
Demerits!
God. So the company I work for, they decided to hire a consulting company and have a new North Star of values the company needs to work for. And one of them is like uplift. And so on our performance reviews, it was like, how would you rate your coworker as your, the person you collaborated on in this project as adhering to or being an exemplary version of uplift? And I'm like, fuck off.
I hate that.
Like, uplift?
Uplift.
Creativity? Suck me through my jorts, loser. Long and hard. Stonks.
Stonks.
Okay. Corporate are numerous.
Mm-hmm. The machine advances characters by way of performance review.
Goody. This looks like a fun time, actually. Yeah. I really like this. Help us!
Yes! Insight cannot be lost, only ever gained.
The nightmare gift that comes from learning the true nature of corporate rot. Love that.
Ooh, it's a good time. This looks...
Here's some insights.
Goody!
I am the Lord of all Carrion Eaters.
Yay!
The winding misery, me.
Me. Moon. The crawling thing, me.
I'm the finality beyond.
Oh wait, no, sorry. Filth unending, me.
Excellent.
As manic a handwriting as possible. Love that.
Amazing. Let's meet some of our staff.
But it is not Friday, and there is no God.
There's no God. TGIF, right?
TGIF.
The upside down men.
Do not turn to look at them. You must not turn to look at them.
Middle management.
Middle management. They lock eyes with other managers and silently nod in acknowledgement. They will play golf this Sunday. Yes, they will play golf. Kill on sight.
Kill on sight. Excellent.
Come visit us at accounting.
Accounting.
Oh, they've got a little map of everything. Accounting. Nice. At the center of the room stands the abacus.
Abacus.
That graphic reminds me of an actual logo of like a tech productivity tool. Also, I cannot for the life of me remember which one, but I swear it's inspired by a real one, which makes it even better.
Under no circumstances are you to go into the basement.
Okay. Ooh. Fun. Neat.
Thanks.
This looks very fun.
Looks really nice.
Looks like a lot of fun. I really like it.
Yeah. So far, a lot of these are real big hits. And again, $5 for this bundle with all this in it.
$5.
Yeah. Just two more. Hold on. Let's get to the top for Rod, Reel, and Fist.
What?
So, it's based on a very specific genre of 80s, 90s anime.
I see. Okay.
So there's a lot in this PDF that we're not going to get. It's 300 pages.
Oh my god.
The man of moss.
There's so many pages. The man of moss. Oh yep. My god.
There's more.
Yeah. Adventures and stuff like that.
Okay.
23 pages of table of contents.
Impressive.
Yeah. Your brother's in a coma or your mortal's fallen sick. Something's gone wrong, and it's not within mortal power to fix it. There is a fish that has the power to reverse this tragedy. But if you can find it and master it, your village will be saved.
Interesting.
God.
Yeah, it's based on the not quite slice of life genre where you just get a fish to cure the orphanage's operation.
There are actually a few Russian fairy tales of fishermen catching a golden fish and getting wishes or, you know, deferring their wishes for a better outcome. That's what this reminds me of.
Yeah, it's kind of like that.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait. Guiding them on their journey will be the swamp being.
Yeah.
Hi, that's me. I'm not the game master. I'm a swamp being. Yeah. So, it's recommended the swamp being be the person with the most experience with role-playing games. If that's no one, experience with board games, video games, improv theater, stage productions, or freestyle rap is a valid substitute.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's go. Optionally allow some light snacks and drinks. But basically, design the village, design the tragedy in the village, find the old region where the Fish of Legend is, and then the Fish of Legend, so that you can find it and get that goddamn fish.
Get that fish.
Yeah. Does a rail line run through the town? Are there bears in this region? What types of soda were available in 80s Japan?
Okay, right. Interesting.
Interesting. And it's a target number system.
Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah. Which is a 1d6 to set against target numbers. And I'm sure there is a way to boost it for target number 7. Oh yeah, equipment, type, and other bonuses. But this is a low lethality game because you're hunting for fish.
Honestly, fuck with that. It's nice to have low lethality systems.
Yeah.
Agreed.
Oh, when a player rolls multiple dice and two or more are the same number, they get combined. So, we combine dice, it's basically multiplied. So, 2 3s become a 5. Oh, so not multiplied, it's weird math.
Interesting.
I don't like weird math.
As the number on the dice, and then, oh god, plus the number of times you rolled it. Fuck off.
Oh, I don't like that.
3, you roll 2 threes, so 3 plus 2, and I know what you're going for. It's very cute that you have anglerfish as your little, No.
We're always like, no, I'm out.
No. I'm sure there are ways to fuck around with it. It's fine.
Yeah, probably.
I mean, this is page 31 out of 288, and like 27 of those pages were table of contents, so there's probably something we're missing. But like for right now, we don't got the time to look through all that. I'm a swamp being.
Swamp being.
The All right. blood.
And last but not least, the blood. Have you ever wanted to play Vampire the Masquerade, but didn't want to support fascism? That's the blood.
Wait. Are White Wolf bad? Okay, I'll look into that later, but like, today I learned, I guess.
I may get the details wrong, but they were like, there are some concentration camps in the Balkans. That's actually a vampire plot, you guys. Here's some Nazi symbolism that's in our game. That's just part and parcel of our game. And people are like, what the fuck, White Wolf?
A little sus. I will say this is a person who runs something that was like, you know, checks watch 100 plus years in the past, but was real history. It sure is a thing that you need to balance carefully, or else. Anyway.
Concentration camps aren't fun to roleplay with.
No.
This is my hot take.
Wow. You know, you say such brave, controversial things, but somebody has to.
So brave, bestie. Anyway, get your hot take out of the freezer.
Anyway, vampires are magic. The blood makes vampire. It isn't evil per se, but the blood doesn't care about ethics. Oh, it can't control you or even alter your emotions, which is something else it has the point over Vampire the Masquerade.
I mean, there are reasons. There are vibes of the game to go either way, but I fuck with this.
Yeah.
Your choices are always your own. Hell yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Many of the tricks people associate with vampires are spells cast more quickly and quietly, because the blood offers it. Yeah. No fascists, here we go!
Yeah!
Nice.
Not allowed in my The Blood.
Tools, consent, and cooperative play. Fly off.
You should probably take some time to educate and heal yourself before anything else.
Yeah.
Heal yourself. I like that. I like that a lot.
I like that.
Nice.
But yeah. Vampires. You know vampires. They magic.
They magic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Atmosphere. Human greed is bad. Vampires are magic. Setting assumes that modern society largely is unchanged and does not account for vampires.
That's fair.
Yeah. So typical Game of the Blood is small group of vampires and they're figuring shit out because they're new vampires. So the most common story is investigation into what the supernatural is and then defend the new territory from the wider supernatural world. So yeah, Vampire the Masquerade, but no fascists.
But no fascists.
No fascists. Yeah, time. Time isn't real. This is a role-playing game.
I like that.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Honestly, telling people that, you know, it's okay to be outside the realm of possibility is very freeing, as opposed to not mentioning it. Just being able to say, hey, don't fucking worry about it. It's good shit.
Don't worry about it. Right. And
D10s.
D10s.
Okay. Yeah, that is very Vampire the Masquerade.
So, threshold is a number that cancels out hits for being difficult, and you want to roll 7 or higher.
Okay.
As long as there is at least one natural hit, you can have negative thresholds too for something that's piss easy. Oh, and if you have no hits, you have options like failing forward.
Thank God. AKA,
yeah, the TTRPG story. Or succeed at a cost.
Also, thank God. Good shit.
Also, thank God. Mm-hmm. So you're taking a shot. The bullet hits, but also goes through someone's window. Which is pretty basic for vampire complications, but I'm sure there are more. Basic success. Permutations, and there are a few universal circumstances, blah, blah, blah. Some mechanics give you an edge.
Yeah.
Edge.
It's the edge. And it differentiates between simple and complex actions, which pretty nice. So, chase scene, complex. Jumping from rooftop, simple. Yeah, we could do a simple action real right now. Let's do it. Let's go leap off a rooftop. You first, Kristen.
Okay, sure. Why not?
Your legs still work,
sure,
don't
I'm
they?
I'm capable of that. Yeah, my legs work. Sure. I can jump off a roof.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So character creation, you got basic concepts, blah, blah, blah. Trained in 5 skills with 20 points of specialties between them. Vampire is all hell. And then comes the magic.
Yeah. Ooh, avocations, spelled funkily.
That's how you know it's magic.
Is that, sorry, is that really how knack is spelled? I look at it, can, and I'm like, is that?
That's how it's spelled.
I believe you, but it looks wrong to me.
Yeah, you can remember it from the hit PS4 game, Knack 2.
Knack 2, baby!
Let's
also,
go!
Also, sorry, I do have hiccups.
It's weird, I had hiccups earlier. I'm sorry I somehow gave them to you through the
internet.
I'm sorry!
How dare you?
It's fine, you just have to be scared by someone, or drink water while... while doing a handstand, or
the ultimate cure is you have someone else ask you what swims in the ocean, and if you answer correctly, the hiccups are cured.
I see. Okay, swims in the ocean?
Yeah,
fish.
Mama always said, put sugar at the roof of your mouth.
Interesting.
It worked.
Damn.
Hell yeah.
Every time, baby.
Now I know the cure.
Connections!
But yeah, a whole bunch of advantages and disadvantages. Very sad man looking at an iPhone right here.
Mood. Me.
Me too.
Me.
His hand is so long.
He's got... Oh my god!
Yowie hands.
Oh my god!
Yowie hands! That's what my hands look like right now after wearing wrist braces
for over a month.
That's what my thumb looks like. Just like that.
Just an extended rod.
Yes. It looks just like that.
This is what fingers look like. Man, my hands are big as hell. They can't fit around an iPhone like that. What kind of iPhones this guy got?
iPhones be small, though, comparatively.
Yeah, I think they're small.
I know they're small. I say as someone with small hands who has that as a fucking phone requirement. Can't be too large.
Same.
And yeah, please, you got to stability.
Stability. So,
mental and physical, complete stability or physical stability lost. Something permanent and horrible happens.
Goody.
And then there's a lot more rules, including bulletproof vest. You know, for vampires.
Yeah, for vampires.
This is a 72-page PDF. Indeed. Yep. Hiccups came back. Oof,
damn it.
Yeah. And then it looks like, hey, we got some world building down here.
Interesting.
So all of that is pretty nice. And with that, that's 100% not the end of all that's in the bundle, which is $5 for trans rights. But that's all I had pulled up because I thought those looked fun. And, like, for the most part, all of them were really fun.
Yeah.
So, Owen Wilson game went.
Owen Wilson game went. Fuck. I forgot about the Owen Wilson game.
We started with Cotton Eye Joe and got all the way here.
God. I love all of them. The Eldritch Office one and the God ones are my favorites, which I know is really surprising. Yeah, well, it's really surprising.
Wow, never could have guessed.
I never would have guessed that those would be my favorite ones. But they look really fun. They seem like a good time. Also, the Owen Wilson one is objectively the best one, obviously.
And I'll say this as someone who has looked through a lot of them. There are a lot of really cool solo journaling RPGs in there as well, so I would recommend taking a gander at those too if you do not have IRL or online friends to play with, aka me, because of my time zone and etc. So
what swims in the ocean?
Fish! I sure hope you cured me for a second time.
I wanna believe. Yeah, it seems like fun.
Yeah. I'd say
and now you have a bajillion one-shot RPGs.
And now I do. I'll say there are definitely some favorites in here. Obviously Apocalypse Wow.
I mean, yes.
And Cotton Eye Joe, also super hit. I will find him and I will kill him.
I will find him and I will kill him. God. Yeah, but I just have nothing but good things to say. It looks fun.
Very fun.
Fucking spin the bottle RPG at meetup once.
Yes, absolutely. We're playing that.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
We're going to spin the bottle for Rulership of Hell. Let's go.
Woo. Let's do it. Yay.
But yeah. This was very fun to look through, offer some commentary on, learn some stories about Dick Slicer.
Dick Van Slicer.
Dick Van Slicer. can someone homebrew Bob Ross into Apocalypse Wow? Absolutely! Clarification's very simple. Pick two stats that he's good at, and you got Bob Ross. Maybe even a Luke Wilson, if you can remember a single Luke Wilson role.
Oh, amazing.
Well, thank you all very much for joining us. We may or may not do something next week. I don't know. It may or may not be one of these games. I don't know. We'll figure it out. But in the meantime, check out the bundle. It's $5. Surely you've got $5 to spare somewhere for trans rights and 500 RPG-related things.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Until next time, thank you. Enjoy tabletop role-playing games. Goodbye.
Bye-bye.